Hello friends, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Neetu Jain, working as Associate Professor at Indian Institute of Public Administration, New Delhi. Today, we are going to discuss about the topic Setting Training Objectives. Before starting the discussion, let's have a look at the contents. Introduction, purpose of training objectives, characteristic of objectives, structure of objectives, components of learning objectives, advantages and disadvantages of objectives, practical use of objectives, and some examples of learning objectives, followed by summary. After completing this module, the students will be able to understand the purpose and characteristics of training objectives, structure and process of setting training objectives, describe various merits and demerits of setting training objectives. The short, medium and long-term benefits of training can only be experienced to the full if training is not only managed professionally but is also linked clearly with the corporate mission or purpose. It is from the corporate mission that more specifically, precisely defined objectives can be set and passed down the organization to form the basis of divisional, departmental and unit objectives, and ultimately objectives for individual workers. Without well-defined training or learning objectives, trainers do not know exactly what is to be taught, learners do not know what is supposed to be learned, and managers do not know what they are investing their training money in. Learning objectives tell them what is to be learned, how well it is to be performed, and under what conditions it is to be performed. Training objectives are broad statements of intent, action and outcome. They articulate final outcomes or the end results of the training. They describe what the participants will be able to do or perform at the end of the training program by way of changes, new developments or improvements in their job or personal behavior. The training objectives provide direction to the training program. They serve as a basis for evaluation. It is a tool for meeting participants' training needs and they define the limits for the program. Purpose of training objectives. If a trainer does not know where he is going, there is little chance of the learner knowing it either. It will lead to wastage of trainees and trainers, time and energy. The key question to ask is, what kind of things should trainee be able to do at the end of the training session? Trainers should have a clear and unambiguous answer to this question. Trainers are frequently required to write training objectives. These should be clear, precise, and unambiguous statements that both trainers and trainee can use. A training objective should contain a statement of performance that includes an action, for example, list, write, drill, type, interview, etc. A question to ask about a statement of performance is whether we can observe or measure it. If not, it is almost certainly too vague and should be improved by including an action word, one that can be observed or measured. The purpose of training objective is to state as clearly as possible what trainees are expected to be able to do at the end of their training, the conditions under which they will demonstrate their learning, and standards that must be reached to confirm their level of competence. Well-written training objectives can be used as a means to validate and evaluate training. They assist trainers to decide upon method and content of training, and they provide trainers with a clear target. Characteristics of objectives. Objectives are intermediate steps that need to be achieved in order to accomplish a goal. They should be written as outcome for the target audience. Objectives should be SMART. This stands for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-based. Specific in the context of developing objectives means that an observable action, behavior or achievement is described, which is also linked to a rate, number, percentage or frequency. Answer the phone quickly can be said to be a precise description of behavior. You can clearly see whether someone answers the phone or not, but there is no rate, number, percentage or frequency linked to it. So, if it is stated, answer the phone within three rings, a rate has been added and the behavior is now much more specific. Measurable. A system, method or procedure has to exist which allows the tracking and recording of the behavior or action upon which the objective is focused. Setting an objective that requires phone calls to be answered in three rings is fine, provided a system exists which measures whether this is actually being achieved. If none exists, the manager must be prepared to set time aside to actually monitor the response rate of incoming phone calls. The only other alternative is to get the person with whom the objectives are being set to measure their own progress. In some cases and situations, it may be acceptable to do this. In other, maybe not. Use common sense to decide this. Achievable. The objectives that are set with people need to be capable of being reached. There is a likelihood of success, but that doesn't mean easy or simple. The objectives need to be stretching and agreed by the parties involved. Setting targets that are plainly ridiculous does not motivate people. Relevant. This means two things, that the goal being set with the individual is something they can actually impact upon or change. Secondly, should be important to the organization as well. Time based. In the objective, somewhere there has to be a date for when the task has to be started and completed. Structure of objectives. An objective has three main parts. The performance, which trainees are expected to display at the end of their training, the conditions under which they will perform, and the standards which they are expected to reach. A set of objectives is a working tool for the trainer, and while they must be clear and accurate in their content, there is some flexibility in their presentation so that those who work from them find them easy to use. Terminal objectives. Terminal objectives are used to indicate that the performance which has been described is what is expected at the end or termination of training. Enabling objectives. Once terminal objectives have been set, it is usually found that it can be broken down into a number of sub-objectives, which are called enabling objectives. Achieving the sub-objectives enables the trainee to achieve the terminal objective. Lesson objectives. A further breakdown of enabling objectives identifies the learning points which make up the parts of a lesson and are described as lesson objectives. Description of learning objectives and their purpose. Training program should be designed by the trainers to achieve certain goals for the learner. Program should also include various learning objectives that when reached culminate in the learner achieving the overall goal of the training program. When designing a training plan, each learning objective should be designed and worded to the extent that others can clearly detect if the objective has been achieved or not. From reading the learning objectives, readers should be able to answer the question, what will the learner be able to do as a result of the learning activities, methods or strategies? Observable action. It describes the observable performance of behavior. An action means a verb must be in the statement. For example, type a memo, load an application into the computer. Each objective covers one behavior, hence only one verb should be present. If there are many behavior or behavior is complicated, then the objective should be broken down into one or more enabling learning objectives that support the main terminal objective. At least one measurable criteria state the level of acceptable performance of the task in terms of quantity, quality, time or limitation. This will answer any question such as how many, how fast, how well. For example, at least 5 correct within 10 minutes without an error, there can be more than one measurable criteria. Do not fall into the trap of putting in a time constraint. Use a time limit only if required under normal working standards. A training objective states what a person will be able to do, a statement of performance expressed in terms that are clear, observable and measurable. An objective uses behavioral terms to describe a person's performance. It defines this by means of an action very linked to knowledge, skills or attitude. All objectives must include an action verb to describe a person's performance or behavior on completion of their training. Typical action verbs include, for knowledge, define, describe, explain, identify, list, state, select. For skill, adjust, assemble, check, fit, load, maintain, operate, repair. For attitudes, agree, distinguish, help, indicate, recognize, verify. Generally, bearing in mind the need to make objectives observable and measurable, behavior is normally expressed to specify either knowledge or skill. Notice that both of these categories of behavior can be measured. You could ask a person to describe knowledge verbally or in writing. This can be at a fairly low order of learning where people recall information, or it can be at a higher order where they have to respond to what check situations. The only problem with measuring verbs such as describe is the time needed to listen or read description and the usually subjective criteria being used to assess what has been described. This is one of the reasons why trainers prefer to help people acquire knowledge or skill to meet their needs. Most of them would run a mile rather than attempt to change a person's attitude. Conditions of performance. It describes the actual conditions under which the task will occur. Also, it identifies the tools, procedures, materials, aids or facilities to be used in performing the task. For example, without reference to a manual or by checking a chart, the learning objective spells out the exact training requirement. The objective specifies what behavior must be displayed to perform the task to standards. Training is then developed to teach the steps. Generally speaking, the conditions give information in one or more of the following categories: the range of learning to be covered, the tools, equipment and clothing to be used, the performance aids and manuals that can or cannot be used, the environmental conditions in which the task is being performed, any special physical or social demands. Standards. The standards of performance state the minimum level of acceptable performance the learner must attain at the end of a learning unit, course or program. Generally speaking, there are two types of standard: accuracy and speed. Example of accuracy standards: the task must be completed without error, all measurements must be within 0.01 millimeter, must work within the technical specification for the job, must state the sequence in the correct order, must be able to name 14 of the 18 components correctly with not more than 3 corrected errors. Example of speed standards: the task must be completed in not more than 10 minutes, the overhaul to be completed in not longer than the time scheduled for the job, the learner must check not less than 5 items per minute, the learner must produce not less than 20 components per hour. Advantages of objectives. By setting objectives, irrelevant and unnecessary content is avoided. Guidelines are also provided for design and planning of the program. Comprehensive advice is given to the trainers about what is expected of them and the program. Objectives provide the base by which the program is validated for success. Without identified objectives at the start of the program, validation at its end is worthless, as it is not measuring any changes. Written objectives provide quantitative material on which any investigation or revision can be based. Objectives prevent teaching too much or too little. They also provide a link between training needs and the training which is delivered so that training can be validated. Disadvantages of objectives. Objectives make training programs inflexible by constraining the trainers to the objectives material alone. Designers and trainers find that writing down of objectives restricts flexibility. Too much time can be expended in formulating objectives and writing them down. Training objectives are seen as behaviorally anchored outcome measures and exclude the program's theory and knowledge content. S36, practical use of objectives. Pre-training phase. Copies of them should be sent to all people concerned and their reaction should be welcomed. When learners are invited to take part in a training program, invitation should include the objectives. This gives them the opportunity to confirm about the suitability of the program. Training phase. Pre-program training material is usually not read, therefore, it is always useful to start your program with a restatement of the objectives. Present or represent the objectives and seek the views of the learners about their relevance and understanding. Display the objectives as part of the introductory session. Objectives, programs and people can be used as or linked with the program evaluation measures, and learners' view can be sought on how they will know at the end of the program whether objectives have been achieved or not. Using objectives directly with the training program underlines the fact that all stages of training and learning cycle are linked. Post-training phase. At the end of training program, validation and evaluation measures are used to check the satisfaction of the objectives against the learning by the participants. Some examples of well-written learning objectives. For example, in the area of communication, the objectives can be written down as, at the end of the training program, participants will be able to explain 5 basic principles of communication, outline 4 barriers and bridges to communication, list at least 3 measures to enhance communication level among team members. In the area of conflict resolution, objectives can be written down as, at the end of the training program, participants will be able to explain at least 5 basic principles of empathetic communication to handle conflict. Develop policy that gives current frontline leaders the permission and expectation to work with other staff on conflict resolution. In the area of stress management, training objective can be written down as, at the end of training program, the participants will be able to list and recognize major symptoms and behaviors related to stress, outline 3 to 5 stress management strategies, list quick strategies staff can use during work shifts as well as at home to reduce stress level. Related to teamwork or positive work environment, objectives can be stated as, at the end of the training program, trainees will be able to identify characteristics of an effective team, describe 4 skills leader can use to foster commitment and collaboration, develop at least 5 guidelines for treating staff with respect and helping staff learn from each other. With regard to constructive criticism, training objectives can be listed as, at the end of the training program, participants will be able to establish clear standards of behavior and that recognize and reward staff when they meet these standards. List ways to approach staff whose performance is a concern and help plan for solutions. Summary. An objective should be precise, clear statement of what the learners will be able to do at the end of a learning unit. This may be an enabling objective because it is at the end of a particular knowledge or skill training session, or it can be the training objective, defining the task the learner will be able to do at the end of a learning unit. For all objectives, there are three elements to be included, or at least considered: a statement of the performance, the conditions under which it will be done, and the standards which will be applied. Thank you.